Acorn started in 1997 in Stockport. Initially, it was started by a group of GPs, including Dr. Jackie Chang, who supported with other consultants, Dr. Brian Lieberman, and some eminent public figures who became trustees. The chief exec originally was Helen Massey Roach, and her journey led her to university, where she completed a social work degree. Part of a placement as a social work degree took her to the Priory, where she was supported by the then director of treatment, Wynne Parry, in setting up the service in Stockport. The service she felt was needed, as poor people couldn't afford the services of the Priory, and quite often their only offer of drug treatment was a methadone script. So she set up ADAS, the Alcohol and Drug Abstinence Service, in a small shop in Stockport with two other members of staff. And initially they were funded through the European Social Fund and the lottery. The shop in Stockport wasn't big enough. After almost a year, they outgrew the premises and they moved to Oak House, further up the A6 in Hazel Grove. This is Oak House. This was our headquarters from 1999 until 2010. We moved from here to Fullstone House, which is maybe three times the size. I've got some sentimental attachment to Oak House, and it's a place that many hundreds of people have got clean and sober. Helen Massey Roach felt that there needed to be higher quality provision for women in the community who had children, some of whom had lost children into care due to their alcoholism or drug addiction. Women, specifically mothers with children, often found it difficult, if not impossible, to access traditional treatment and residential rehab. So Helen started ADAS. And when it started as a daycare treatment centre. There was no residential facility. He came during the day and went home at night. Quite quickly, there were several clients who failed because their lives were so chaotic in the evening. They returned to the accommodation, which quite often was bail hostels or transitory local authority accommodation, and the place was awash with drugs and alcohol, and they would invariably relapse. In 2003, we opened our first residential, Acorn House, in Leven June. Acorn provided 6 beds of accommodation, mainly, well, for men who had mainly left prison or were homeless. Acorn has been one of our most successful projects and still claims 100% crime reduction yield. During the stay at Acorn, no one has ever committed an offence. When they leave, they may do, but not during the stay at Acorn. And I think that's a statistic I'm quite proud of, and one that the likes of Strangeways or Forest Bank or any of the local prisons couldn't even own. Today we provide tier 2, 3 and 4 services across the north of England, from Morecambe in the west to Hull in the east.
My name's Rob Rogers, Acorn manager for the Hull area. Currently developing the RAMP group, Deep group and some smart recovery groups for the Hull area.
Acorn's primary purpose or primary aim is to carry a message that there is a solution to active addiction. The general consensus appears to be from professionals and the BMA is that addiction or drug addiction is a chronic relapsing condition. I don't believe that. We don't believe that. Acorn prides itself in its programs and its projects. The projects are all of a high standard. One of the yardsticks for any of our housing is that if you wouldn't stay there, don't expect anyone else to stay there. This is Rosemary Court. Rosemary was our second large supported housing project. 8 people live in Rosemary Court and attend treatment on a daily basis at Full Stone House, which is less than a quarter of a mile away. After leaving here, they move on to second stage accommodation at Magda Road and then move into move on accommodation, which provides 24 beds locally in the Stockport area. Acorn take pride in the robust nature of our programmes. We have 4 main programmes, starting from pre-treatment engagement, which is the reduction and motivation programme. We believe that people who are trapped in addiction quite often lose the will to move from active addiction into recovery. Their mood is most often characterised by desperation and despair. And the RAMPS job, or the reduction of motivations job, is to move them from that place to a place of hope.
Because addiction and awareness don't go. So if we can raise awareness for people on the ramp about what's really going on, they will make some decisions. I've not met anyone who's used too much, who's done too much jail, hurt too many members of the family, to crack on and have a nice life if they want it. And abstinence is just another choice. But a lot of us in addiction believe that we can't have that. The ramp's there to smash that to bits, hopefully. It's an HMP Forest Bank, HMP Butley Hall, Oldham, Rochdale, Trafford, Tameside, Stockport, Atkinson, Burnley, Clitheroe, around East Lancashire, Hull and Macclesfield.
Our primary programmes are both 12-step and a cognitive or eclectic programme that is quite intensive, called the DEEP. The DEEP is an acronym for the Dependency and Emotional Attachment Programme.
Sort of give you a sort of rough sketch of, or sort of outline of what the programme is about. It's about bonding, it's about attachments, it's about starting to build confidence within, it's about starting the individual to get to know who they truly are. Self-discovery, you know, sort of quite big, bold words, but it actually, through the right environment, it can happen, and does happen.
And I was doing the NA programme, but I realised that that wasn't dealing with my emotional issues. And I've dealt with things in my life that I never thought I'd be able to deal with. I've had quite a checkered past, you know, with crime, drugs, lots of different problems, and it came to a point when I thought, how am I going to deal with all this?
And we reconnect people with healthier attachments, healthier relationships with the families, the friends, and the wider recovery community.
With my family, extended family group, and they were told about what addiction is. And when that was explained to them, I got a lot of support from my family. Because prior to that, I was going to be sent off to Pakistan to get sorted out.
The DEEP is very, very intensive and uses elements of psychodrama and gestalt, transactional analysis, psychodynamic approaches. It's a very, very good, intensive and structured programme that runs over 12 weeks. Our other programme, the 12-step programme, has been operating for since our inception in almost 15 years ago, and it's proven to be very, very effective.
12-step program, it's all the basic skills I need to, you know, to lead a better life through the intense group therapy. I was able to work on my behaviours and negative thinking. It also gave me an insight into what positive attributes I've got, how to use them constructively.
All the research suggests that this type of intervention provides long-term treatment outcomes for some of the area's most socially deprived people. It also provides a social network and a support network through the fellowships of Alcoholics Anonymous, Narcotics Anonymous and Cocaine Anonymous. Acorn started in Stockport in 1997. We've maintained quite a large presence, and it's still probably one of the areas that we provide the largest recovery community. We provide 14 fully staffed residential treatment houses, and we also have 8 move on houses which provide 24 beds. So somewhere approaching 40 beds for people in the Stockport area, which is really our largest residential service. Over the back is a church, St Mary's, that you can probably see. At the bottom of St Mary's, near the market, is our first social enterprise, a shop called Restore. The shop provides work placements and employment to a number of our ex-clients who restore and sell furniture. There's also going to be a cafe running from there in the next couple of months, and that'll provide work placements in the catering industry and some MBQs. And working alongside our ETE worker, people will be able to move into full-time employment. Last year we provided 41 people access to full-time employment who've maintained that for over a year.
We've just taken over the Independence Initiative contract. It will now be called the Recovery and Reintegration Service. So it's really exciting times for Acorn. We're going to start the development of a brand new service, including the RAM program, our Dependency Emotional Attachment program, which is our abstinence program, and really start focusing our efforts on the reintegration aspects of recovery, which is looking in the long term at housing, recovery housing, our back to work programs, possibly social enterprises. We are very ambitious, around setting up the infrastructure to support people to move through the drug treatment system.
This will provide a real exit for the clients. We're going into a beautiful new treatment centre. We're going to be providing abstinence interventions. We're going to be looking at the kind of reintegration stuff. So for the service users, I think it's going to create a real pathway to move out of the treatment system and start reintegrating and getting back into work, getting back with families. So I think it's really exciting for the clients.
Wow, do you know what I'm saying? You know what? I've been there. I love all yous because you're the same as me. And you know what? I'm here to help. And I care about each one of you is all the same. And, you know, that's my priority. I come here to try and get one or more of yous to where I'm at, or to on the road to where I'm at. And that's my job done.